What is this?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Oh. What is it? It looks like green tea. Oh. Green tea with foam on top of it.
What is it? That's like how his mating call. It's his mating call after he likes something. So you drink a lot of coffee.
I do, man. I love it. I mean, for me, at least three or four cups of coffee a day.
But don't you? Playing.
I need that buzz.
Don't you get heart palpitations?
Nope.
Like, really?
And the only reason is I have it milk-based. If I don't have it milk-based, I don't drink if it's not milk-based coffee.
So what is it? Are you a cappuccino, a latte kind of guy?
Or? Cappuccino or flat white?
Flat white, oh.
Yeah.
My brother always had the sort of like, you know, those who are coffee connoisseurs happen to either also be poets or writers.
Yes, what? Sir.
Yeah, I don't know why. Omar genuinely believes if you know coffee so well, because it's like an old Arabic poet's ritual. You know?
Oh, you mean the like coffee, the fanan?
Yeah, like you have that day. Experience, right?
And also it comes with the glasses.
Exactly. So I feel like you're part of that process.
You seem poetic. You seem poetic to me.
You know, whenever you ask someone, like, let's meet up. What do you say? You say, let's meet up for coffee. Like, nobody says, let's meet up for tea or I don't know.
Let's like, shabab gumna karak.
Tea and yoga, we amelo tea.
Yeah.
No, I think it
is. No, like okay. The whole thing, bro.
There's actually someone, without mentioning the name, okay, there's this guy who owns one of the largest coffee companies in the world. And it's such a big deal that he insured his tongue.
Oh my God, so he's a connoisseur? What?
Exactly. He insured.
So he has insurance on his tongue.
He has insurance on his tongue.
It's like Roberto Carlos and stuff like that.
$10 million.
Wow.
$10 million, he insured his tongue. That is called
a connoisseur.
See? A connoisseur.
That's
a
genuine connoisseur.
What's your tongue worth?
After the kind of food he eats.
Yeah, yeah.
Close. After I speak to you, 3 dirhams.
What's the future that you imagine for the UAE, for the Arab world, for the world? Like, what is the future that you imagine?
When you have something called the Dubai Future Foundation, and underneath it called the Dubai Future Accelerator, and then they have something else called 10X. Yeah. So what's 10X, for example? I think you asked me this question.
I did ask you earlier.
So 10X, literally, 10X is a concept which is adopted by some big, like multinational companies like Google and Facebook and the rest of them. And it's about how do you be 10 times ahead of the game? So Dubai wants to be 10 times ahead of other cities in the world. Because before, if you remember all these superlatives, like Dubai want to be the biggest, the fastest, the first, etc. But now they want to be 10 times ahead. So that's the difference. There's so many other things that we are connected with than what we see in traditional media.
Yeah.
So luckily there's new media that's killing it.
Yeah, that's us.
And that's why
right.
More people like you to be showing this.
Thank you. And
our voice is the one that needs to go out more than I think the traditional media. But maybe we just need to be bought by Rupert Murdoch or something. Hi, my name is Omar AlBusaidi and you're watching Dine with Dukkan.